My name is Nichole Cameron, and I work at Patten Towers here downtown. I've been there for just about 7 years. I came here from Ohio, from Cleveland, Ohio, the real Cleveland. And I do miss up north, but I do like it down here. So that's me, and thank you for welcoming me to your city. It was so quaint and so nice, and then I love the local food. So that's one of the things that really drew me to Chattanooga, was like the atmosphere. I like the vibe of the people. Like I said, the local fresh restaurants, the local restaurants with the fresh ingredients. They have local produce. I love that. I hate the parking. It's like terrible. I don't like the traffic. However, with COVID-19, that changed so much. Like, the traffic has changed. It's almost like, especially when it first hit, it was a ghost town. I was hoping I would have been one of the people where they were like, oh, you can work from home, but I was considered essential. I haven't caught COVID-19, so I'm not contagious. But, you know, I've been working the whole time, so I've seen like a big change, because even though they started opening businesses, they've been reopening businesses and everything, it's still like very slow down here, and the traffic is very light, which, because I walk downtown on my lunch break, I like to at least walk to get my exercise in, so if I'm not gonna walk after work, and I know I'm not walking before work, I hit snooze all the time. But I know that I'm not necessarily gonna walk after work. I try to walk on my lunch break. So I just noticed that everything is just so light. The traffic is light. It helps me cross the street better, and it helps me get to work faster. I love that. So we went to the Juneteenth celebration, and there was just like, it wasn't just all black people, it was everyone. And I really did enjoy it. But you know, I hate the fact that the death of George Floyd is what has brought everyone together. I hate that he really had, like, his life was sacrificed for us to all get together. But I really hope and pray that his death is not in vain. So I hope and pray that change comes from this. I hope that people wake up and really like check their biases. And I know we talk a lot about racism, and I think sometimes when you talk about racism, you think white against black, but there's a lot of racist black people too, and that is equally as bad. And I'm all about black pride and everything, and black pride is very important, because there's no other group of people instilling black pride in us. So that has to be instilled from your village. My mother instilled black pride in me. My father and the group of people that raised me, they all instilled black pride in me. But that, just because I have black pride, does not mean that I'm against my white brother or sister. That's not what I'm about. I'm a people person. I'm a people lover. So I just love all people, and I embrace diversity. I mean, I don't think that it's a coincidence that we don't all look alike. We all need that. Like, we all need balance. We need balance in our life. We need, like, I need someone who's sassy and who can get you together. But then you also need someone who's a peacemaker like myself, and someone who's laid back. You know, you need balance like that, and you can't just have everybody looking white, you can't have everybody being black, you have to have the unity. So that's what I'm all about, is unity. I love everybody. It's your girl Nick. I love everybody, and I'm all about unity. But we have to get this racial thing together. We really do. And I think when we wake up and realize that we are all a part of the human race. I know that's something people say all the time, but we're like all a part of the human race. We're all here trying to make it from A to B. We're all, when we all pass away, they say the most important thing on your gravestone is the dash. What did you do during that dash? That is what the most important thing is. And it's not about being black. It's not about being white. It's about being human and doing what you're supposed to do. That's my story, and that's what my piece is. Black power.